All right, I've only ridden this once, but has some pretty exciting little sections. See how fast I can get through it. The camera's been overheating at like 34 minutes. I think it's probably something to do with the SD card. I think I probably have the wrong SD card type in there based on other people's reviews. But why upgrade when you just can work around a problem? You have a workaround to a problem, it's not really an issue. Just pedal faster, right? Cram it all in 34 minutes. So current plan is run this trail all the way to the end and then take the road back. Yeah, there goes some dirt. I wonder where you were. Oh, forgot to track it. At least track the ride and maybe put statistics in the video somehow, or link it in the description. That's probably the easiest way. We'll see how it goes. Currently have it on pedal assist 4. I recently reset all the settings back to stock. So today I was looking up details on the on this bike and saw that supposedly it's 62 pounds. I knew it was heavy, but holy crap, that is super heavy. Need to weigh it to validate that number. Can't believe anything. Can't believe everything you see on the internet. But it was from a e-bike reviewer. Gotta say though, in the trails, as long as you got assist on, this thing is pretty awesome. I tried turning off assist the other day whenever I was riding with my daughter. She was on a non-electric bike. And yeah, it was definitely boggy trying to pedal this thing up and down hills. Doesn't quite have enough low gears to crawl up hills like a mountain bike does. A mountain bike, you can really shift that puppy down quite a bit and just kind of just walk it right up the hill, just nice and slow. But this thing doesn't have a lowered gears on the front derailleur. It only has gears in the back, which is plenty, even up pretty tough hills. As long as you got the engine, as long as you got the electric motor helping you. All right, got somebody else left doing the trail. If they had a bike rack, should look through that. Hey, how's it going, y'all? Thank you so much. How are y'all doing today? Having a nice, awesome walk? Thank you so much. You're good. You can sniff. Even take a bite if you need to. Y'all have a good day. All right. Plenty of blazes on the trail. Wonder what's all that about. Wonder if they're just trying to, I don't know. Y'all have to let me know in the comments of what the max speed was as I was riding. Trails are weavy enough and slick enough where I can't really pay attention. I'm enjoying the line. Absolutely beautiful. This bike is 62 pounds. It feels great as long as that motor's going. feel like Superman on a mountain bike going through the trails. Awesome. Exciting. Nice and moist back there. Definitely been struggling up that if I didn't have battery power. Just the gears just don't quite go low enough with no battery. So the key is, don't run out of battery. Here, goodness gracious, washing all these things out. Random carpet. That was a little lower than I expected. Oh yeah. About 10 miles an hour up this hill. I don't know that I could have did that on a regular mountain bike, even whenever I was in the best shape of my life in my 20s. I do love that automatic motor kill as soon as you touch the brake lever. I usually do that to modulate the power around corners. It's still pushing too hard around the corner. Barely touch that brake and just to get it to back off. Overshifted. That's not good. Glad I caught it before. Did any damage. Pushed too hard to go up another gear. I must needed to adjust my derailleur. Definitely find all the spider webs today. Thank you. Oh, I did it again. I'm gonna have to adjust that. Which way does it go? Looser. We'll do 2 clicks looser. Hopefully that's good. Oh, that thumb throttle is nice. Oh, did I do it again? Two clicks might be too much. That's the wrong direction. Yowzers. Yeah, that's the wrong direction. I'm gonna make a mess. Yikes. All right, let's try that. 2 clicks back the other way then. Let's see where we stand here. Oh, right on the best part of the trail too. Right where it starts to get interesting. How are we doing? Ah, beating it again. I'm gonna have to figure that out. What the heck, dude? Let's go back one. Or have I messed up something else? Something else bent? It's possible that I bent something. Eee. Suckage. Alright. Walk shame. Can't pedal up the hill. Gotta walk it. I done did something. Something is not right. Use the thumb throttle, ease on up, pedal lightly. All don't know what it's doing. It is not happy though. I guess I'm gonna be learning about rear derailleur mount maintenance again. Oh, very nice. Oh. Back brake rotor has some type of oil or something on it, some type of contaminant. Tried to spray it off without taking the wheel off the other day. It just didn't get to the pads well enough. I think I might have to pull the wheel and hit the pads good. Makes a nice chunky sound whenever I'm pulling on it too hard. Tried to wait until the last minute to brake just to make that sound, but running off the trail instead. Ooh, that's washed out a little bit. Oh yeah, very nice. Not a good sound. I guess that's the sound of the chain derailing because I hopped over all that crap. Well, I guess I got a lot to learn about derailleur maintenance. This little part right there and chain jacked up on me. Oh, I'm gonna have to walk a shame because I'm in too low a gear. Not a good line. Yep, gotta say, darn commuter bike. We'll see how much longer it'll hold up than me treating it like a mountain bike. What parts are gonna fall off first? I love the fenders. I don't want them to fall off. I like not getting sprayed. Whenever you hit just a little patch of water or mud or something, it's very nice not to get sprayed. Thank you. sun's going down. Slightly bumpy. Ooh. Yep. Definitely some water moving through this area. Roots all kinds of exposed. Spiderwebs in my face, man. Did start the tracking a little late. Palmetto Boardwalk,
very nice. Nice.
We're close.
Very, very close now. What is this?
Ooh, another trail. This is part of the trail system for the McCready trail system. Palmetto Trail just kind of runs through it. Mile 15 is where the bat shelter is. Back to the truck. So it's 5.89 so far, 37 minutes. How long I've been tracking it. Right. 2,104 miles on the odometer of the bike, and I'm at 79% battery. That means that I can pretty much run this thing full bore level 5 all the way home. Oh yeah, I got plenty of battery now. More than likely, the camera's going to turn off on the way back, but I'll post details in the description on total trip and stuff, if it makes sense. But that's definitely a good segment that's really close to my house. I like it. Probably start taking that one a little more often. I need to turn on my light. There we go, that's better. Now they might actually see me and go around me instead of hitting me. Hopefully. Oh yeah. I need to sit back, hit the throttle a little bit even. Got so much extra battery left. Through there. Congress Road on the left hand side. Yep, pedaling up this hill with full pedal assist 5 on. Going at 19 miles an hour. That is absurdly awesome. After that. That's nice. The other day I tried to do a 10-mile section of this and then pedal home on the road. I don't know the exact mileage that I went, but the battery was at 13%. It starts cutting out, limiting motor output at 15%. I think it drops down to like 400 watts at 15%, and then like 250 under 10, something like that. But yeah, this is a luxury right here. Get to do all that fun riding on the trails, plenty of power, and then just kind of cruise home. That's real nice.
rumble strip definitely slows you down quite quickly. Down to 36% battery. Battery goes quick when you're giving it all out. Catching a whole bunch of wind resistance over that 20 mile an hour speed. Thank you. 10.6 so far. Back 109 miles back to Weston Lake, and did it in 51 minutes and 11 miles and 11.19.